We're going to test the Infinix Smart 5A, also called as 5, to cover all aspects of its build quality. An ultra-budget device costing under 6.7K at the moment. Cheap may not always mean cheap build quality, since we have seen a lot of budget devices with sturdy builds. So we are expecting the same on the Infinix Smart 5A as well. No pre-applied plastic protector on this one, present on all BBK devices, even on Mi devices these days. An initial good news, at least for now, is that the structural build quality seems quite sturdy in my usual trial bend. Other stuff in the box is a weird dollar note, a SIM ejector pin. The plastic protector is actually present, just not pre-applied. A rare hard plastic case, which doesn't quite protect on all sides, especially from the display side. A disappointing micro USB cable in 2021, and a 10W adapter. Can't really complain at this extreme budget price. In this crash test, we will test the practical scratch resistance quality of this unnamed glass protection on the IPS LCD display by seriously rubbing it with common atoms and a heavy-duty blade. High-quality tempered glass protections like Corning are always able to survive the blade, but there are a lot of BBK devices which have consistently failed the blade, even though it's not supposed to, according to the Mohs scale of hardness, since glass is harder than steel. That's why the blade is the most important scratch test tool. Will the unnamed tempered glass protection be able to pass the blade? Surprisingly, even though the tempered glass protection is unknown, it still somehow manages to pass a scratch test. The Infinix Smart 5 or 5A obviously doesn't have any kind of water resistance or IP rating like IP53 or such because of its extreme low pricing. So we are expecting it to have low liquid damage resistance. But anyways, every device we have tested, besides most budget BBK devices, do have oleophobic coating which helps in smudges and dirt and gives a smooth feel while operating the touchscreen. The Smart 5 or 5A doesn't have 100% of oleophobic coating. It's more like 50% since the water isn't forming perfect drops, but neither is it lying flat on the surface. The big issue here is the most common one we face. The prolonged audio distortion and low volume levels took more than 30 minutes to recover, signifying early stages of liquid damage, due to which it fails the test, not even able to reach the light splashing round. Next up, in the drop test, dropping the Smart 5 or 5A from 4 different angles and 2 heights. First drop from pocket height, bottom side facing down. Next up, the last pocket height drop, unnamed glass protection and display side facing down. We have never really had a device fail or shatter in a pocket height drop. Apart from the LG K42, which had that fake military standard, and we dropped it on purpose on a rough cement surface. but the Infinix Smart 5 or 5A unfortunately shatters in the first pocket display side drop and fails the drop test. Buying insurance becomes mandatory and an absolute necessity since the drop impact resistance is pretty weak. So now we know that the unnamed glass protection can easily fail even from low drops. But what about its structural integrity? Next up, we are going to video proof the structural build quality through the bend test, which exposes the few weak phones we sometimes come across. The Smart 5A seems to be somewhat flexing with a good bit of bend degree, but it kind of feels sturdy for an extreme budget device. Again, a similar amount of flex degree from the plastic backside pressure. No kinks or breaks near traditionally weaker areas like the power button or SIM tray, screen separation or any kind of damage or breaks to the plastic structure. It's great news that at least Infinix has done a good job on the low-priced Smart 5A, as the plastic build easily passes the bend test.